Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Fishing the West. I apologize for the huge gap of no videos in between. I believe it was close to the start of August is when I really stopped making them. But I'm back up in business, and I'm gonna start making some more videos. It was mainly just getting started with school. I'm gonna be a freshman. Well, I am a freshman now. So, I had to get my bearings straight, had to get everything ready, and make sure I was on the right track before I, could think about more about fishing and making videos. And I've actually been unable to fish a whole lot, but I've gotten out in the water a few. So, right now I'm just going to show you some tackle, some mainly plastics and jigs, and a swim bait that I've been kind of building up through this gap of videos. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and keep on staying tuned. First off, we've got a pepper jig right here, and one of my favorite jigs to use. Early summer, midsummer, simple football head on it, silicone ties on it are a little bit different, kind of like the same as a mop jig or one of the Buckeye mop jigs, and I've just got it with a not a sweet beaver. But a Smalley Beaver. I'm not sure what color that is. Something Red Flake. I believe that's Watermelon Red Flake. But a pretty cool jig. Love the jig. Right here is just a Punchin' Jig. I'm not familiar with the brand. I kind of forgot since I purchased it a long time ago. But it's a half ounce jig. Rattler in the back. Simple hook. And it's kind of in a dark watermelon, something like that. A dark brown color. A little bit of speck. This is just a finesse jig made by Spro, something I'd kind of use on a spinning setup. Really light. I'm not even sure if this is 3/8 ounce, but it's pretty cool. Got a slow drop to it, and I really like it. This right here is another just a grass punching jig. I like to throw in the weeds, lily pads. Have had a lot of luck with this. It's got a baby pocket, or I believe this is a baby pocket crawl on it. And a lot of luck with this. I believe that's Alabama color. Pocket Craw right there, as you can see. This is a new company that I've kind of discovered. It's not new, but found it on Tackle Warehouse. It's Asakura Jigs. I believe that's how you pronounce it. One of my favorite types of jigs. You've got the bent of the jig head right there, which can slide across some gravel, some rocks. Or some grass. It's got the eyes on it. I love the eyes. I love the shape of the jig head, and it's got the wide gap hook. And I think that's a big thing that a lot of jig companies miss, is the wide gap hook. Love the wide gap hooks. Same style jig. You got Sakura jigs, and just in a different color. Moving on, we've got a Huddleston Deluxe Trout Swim Bait. This is in a Smoke Phantom color. I've used them before, but never have owned my own. Huddleston Deluxe, the HUDs, but I'm looking forward to using it. Pretty cool swim bait. Really detailed and lifelike. Right here, it's got some simple flick shakes. I'm getting more into the flick shake fishing as I continue the fall. Really like flick shakes, and have had some luck on it lately. Right here, we've got the Gary Yamamoto Fat Ikas or Fat Ikas, 4-inch in a black red flick color. Like I said, a lot of luck on these guys too, rigging them backwards. Not like a tube, not like an original tube, but where you put the end of the hook in the back where you've got the frills. A little Yum Dinger right here. 4-inch and Watermelon Gold Flake. Had a lot of luck with these, flick shaking them. Next, we've got the Craw Poppies, the Yum LPT Craw Poppies, in just a regular crawdad color. These are pretty big baits, 4.5-inch. 5-inch Yum Dinger Black and Blue Swirl. A lot of people ask me why I use so many of these Yum Dingers. First of all, I would mainly be going with Gary Yamamoto, but they do break easily. They do tear really easily when casting, when hook setting, stuff like that, and they are expensive. And, a bass angler just can't afford to spend, six or $7 on a pack of worms. I like that often. So, you have to go with the Yum Dingers. Another LPT, Yum Dingers, Smoke Pro Laminate. And right in the back, you've got the new series F-Squared F-squared or the F2 ferocities, whatever you want to call it. Yamdinger and Bream color. It's a 12-pack, and it's in a 5-inch, as you can see right there. Pretty cool stuff. Sorry for the dark lighting. I'm just sitting right here near the window. Up next, we've got the True Tungsten weighted soft plastics hand-poured flukes. It's got the underbelly right there to put the, you know, like a 4-0, 3-0, mainly 3-0 hook right there. Pretty lifelike, as you can see. I'll zoom in on a little bit. Really like that look to it. I was on sale for Tackle Warehouse for like $2, so I decided to pick it up. This right here is a bait that I really am fond of. It's really inexpensive. It's made by Zoom. It's the just the regular Magnum Finesse. And it's just in a regular motor oil black color. Really like these. Flick shaking them, believe it or not. Really great action. Inexpensive, but you know, just because it's inexpensive doesn't mean it's not going to work. I caught a lot of fish on those. This right here is the U-tail red shad. Picked them up for a really good price. Thought I might try it out. A little finesse fishing. Not really finesse, but you know, shake head, stuff like that. And right here, you've got your 20-pack of trick worms in black ruby color. And I believe these are 7-inch? I don't know. It doesn't say, but they're big. So as you can see right there, pretty cool stuff. Moving on, we've got the Reaction Innovation Sweet Beavers in water bug color. Great with going on one of these jigs right here, or with a little bit of brown. I think of a black and brown jig goes perfect with this color, and I love using black and brown. Black and brown and black and blue is one of my favorite colors. Also, just blue and brown is also one of my favorite colors as well for jigs and Texas friggin' plastics. This right here is a Grande Bass Mega Claws 4-inch Blue Fleck, and it was actually featured on Tackle Warehouse. I decided to pick it up. It wasn't too expensive, and it looks like a really good flip bait, so I'm anxious to try this out. Kind of like an alternative to you know, like the Berkeley Crazy Tail Craws or Crazy Tail Trigger Craws. I don't know what they're called, but it looks very similar, but a little bit more inexpensive and versatile. Right back there, we've got the Damiki Hydras. This is the 3-inch, I believe, 10 in a pack. And this is just in a blue with a, or a black with a blue flake. Right here, we've got some more Damiki Hydras. And that's just a red with a black, or blue flake, I believe. Back here, we've got the Power Team Lures. And this is pretty interesting. One of those baits that was also featured on Tackle Warehouse. And as you can see, it's 4.5-inch Conviction Craw. Not too sure about this bait. I wanted to try it out though. Really big package. That's my hand compared to the package, and it's wider than my hand is. So it's pretty cool. Anyways, I just want to show you guys some of the new tackle that I've been stocking up on. I will be having a contest today in this video. I'll be giving away this pack of Damiki Hydras. And there's 10 in here. It's in ruby color. And pretty cool stuff. It's the 3-inch. So it's not the only big one, but it's still really good bait. Throwing on a little jig head or something like that. All you need to do is put down a comment on a lure purchase or a fish that you caught over the weekend. Something cool, new, interesting. And you'll be randomly chose. The quality of your comment doesn't matter about your chance of winning. It's mainly just if you comment. And I'll be doing a random drawing, kind of like a hat drawing, in a week or so, probably on Saturday, next Saturday. So, hope you enter. I'll be fishing tomorrow with some flick shakes, some jigs, and some plastics. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and we'll let you guys know that I'm back with Fishing the Midwest.